नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जय मुदीरये। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम सेकंड कैंटो थर्ड चैप्टर टेक्स्ट नंबर 23। सोनका इज कंटिन्यूइंग टू स्पीक एंड ही इज बेसिकली speaking against the people who do not take to devotional service. So first he said that their life is a waste and they are like animals, although looking like human beings. And then he started explaining how their each sense is worthless if it is not used in the service of the Lord. So he continues to speak in the same vein. And now in this verse he says, Jiva chavo bhagavatam ghrirenum na jatu martyo vilabheta yastu Sri Vishnu padya manujastu lashyaha swasan chavo yastu na veda gandham. A person who has not bathed himself in the dust from the feet of a devotee, he is a walking corpse. And one who has not smelled the fragrance from the lotus tulsi leaves which have been offered to the feet of the Lord, he is like a breathing dead body. So this is how he concludes, that person, if he is not getting the dust from the feet of a devotee, which means if he is not doing any service, otherwise dust has no meaning. You can get plenty of that in India. So getting dust means to do service. And as we have been reading before, devotion comes by the grace of a devotee or the Supreme Lord himself. So if one does not associate with a devotee and do service, then it is not possible to engage in devotional activities. And if one is not engaging in devotional activities, then all the verses which were spoken before, describing the uselessness of human body, they apply to such a person. And therefore he is called Jivan Chava. Means, although he is living, he is dead. Because the purpose of life is to engage in bhakti, and if he is not engaging in bhakti, then he is like a dead person. And then similarly he says that if he has not smelled the fragrance of tulsi which has been offered to the lotus feet of the Lord, which means that he is not doing service to the deities. Because if one should do service to the devotee or to the deity of the Lord, going to the temple, doing parikrama, seeing the form of the Lord, performing aarti, offering tulsi to the feet of the Lord, these are the parts of deity worship. And if one is not doing that, then he says that he is swasan chava, he is just a breathing corpse. So even to associate with such people will make one impure. श्री विश्वनाथ चक्रवर्ती सेज एकैकानि अंगानि निंदित्वा समुदितानि निंदति, दैट आफ्टर क्रिटिसाइजिंग इंडिविजुअल सेंसेस ऑफ अ पर्सन ही कलेक्टिवली क्रिटिसाइजेस द कंप्लीट बॉडी विच हैज द डिफरेंट सेंसेस इन दिस वर्ल्ड। सो अर्लियर ही हैज क्रिटिसाइज्ड द आईज if they don't see the form of the Lord, and said they are just like the plumes of a peacock feather, and the ears are like the holes of snake if one does not hear Krishna Katha and so on. And now he says that his whole body is like a dead. Na vilabhet abhito nas prashet sarvangeshu na dhariye iti artha. If one does not smear his body with the dust from the feet of a devotee, sa jiva chava, then he is like a living कार्प्स प्रेत शरीर विशेष चेष्ट मान साधुन भीषयते जस्ट लाइक ए घोस्ट द घोस्ट दे ऑक्यूपाई समबडीज बॉडी एंड पजेस समबडी सो दैट पर्सन्स बॉडी इज जस्ट लाइक डेड बॉडी बिकॉज ही इज नॉट फंक्शनिंग विद हिज ओन माइंड सो ही सेज दैट सच अ पर्सन इज ऑल्सो लाइक ए घोस्ट and he only causes fear to the saintly people just as people have fear from a ghost so sadhus the devotees they have fear from such people tat pani krit sapariyadikam api bhagwan ne grihnati iti bhava and if such a person performs any activity then it is not acceptable as a service to the lord श्री विष्णुपद्यः विष्णुपद लग्नत्वेन विष्णुपदी इति अभिधानः तुलस्या गंधम न वेद अवग्रह नाभिनंदेत इत्यर्थः श्वसन छव पूर्वत स्वपि जीवन छव एंड सिमिलरली हु हैज नेवर स्मेल्ड द फ्रेग्रेंस फ्रॉम द लीफ ऑफर्ड टू द फीट ऑफ द लॉर्ड देन ही इज आल्सो ब्रीदिंग कॉर्प्स सो अप टू दिस वर्स नंबर 23 He has explained the worthlessness of the human body if it is not used in the service of the Lord. At least if one of the senses is used to render service, then the life becomes meaningful. And now he completes his criticism in this verse number 24 and speaks about the hard nature of the heart of a person who is not devoted to the Lord. Tadasmasaram hirdayam vatedam yad griyamanair hari naam dheyaihi nevikriyetath yada vikaro netre jalam gatra ruhe suharshah says that one should consider the heart of a person which does not melt when he takes the names of the Lord, then the heart of such a person is just like steel. Na vikriyeta atha yada vikaro netre jalam gatra ruhe suharsha. And there are no transformations in the body, no tears in the eyes, and there is no happiness expressed with the erection of hair on the body. So says that if the person he is chanting the name of the Lord or he hears the name of the Lord but there is no changes which occur in the body, that means the heart is very hard. So there is a very nice commentary on this verse by Vishnu Chakravarti. Will read that. तदेवं व्यस्त समस्ततया बाह्यमंगं प्राधान्येन निंदित्वा आभ्यंतरमपि निंदति तत् अस्मसारं लोहमयम् एव हृदयम् सो ही सेज दैट इन द प्रीवियस वर्सेस ही हैज क्रिटिसाइज्ड द एक्सटर्नल सेंसेस ऑफ अ पर्सन इफ दे आर नॉट यूज्ड इन द सर्विस ऑफ द लॉर्ड इन विजुअली एज वेल एज कलेक्टिवली एंड नाउ He speaks of the internal sense, that is the heart. That even the heart of such a person is like steel, which means that it is worthless because it cannot help anybody. Yat khalu grihyamanaihi kirtyamanairapi bahubhir harinam dhayer na vikriyet. That even if one chants the name of the Lord, then still there is no transformation, no change, there are no symptoms of love manifest in the heart. Vikriya lakshanam aha atha ityadi. And then he talks about the symptoms, that what are the transformations which should occur in a person by chanting the name. Gatra ruhesu romasu harsha romancha. That the hairs are standing on their end Just as when a person is very happy, then there is some symptoms manifest in the body. Bahunam grahane api chitta drava bhavo nama pradha lingam iti sandarbha. He is quoting from Jiva Goswami's Sandarbha. He says that if a person chants the name of the Lord repeatedly and there is no melting of the heart, then it is to be understood that the person has committed offense, and that's why there is no change in the body or in the heart, because offenses, they obstruct the manifestation of devotion in the heart. If there is no offense, then when one chants, one will immediately manifest his symptoms. So this is the commentary of Jiva Goswami. He has done some analysis in Bhakti Sandarbha, and Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur is quoting from there. Kincha apulakau eva chitra drava lingam iti api na shakyate vaktam. Now Vishwanatha Chakravarti, he does further deliberation on it. He says, is it necessary that somebody chants the name of the Lord and there are no manifestations of these symptoms? So does it mean that his heart has not melted? It may be possible that somebody's heart melts, but he does not manifest any external symptoms. It may also be possible that somebody manifests external symptoms and his heart does not melt. There are people who can act very nicely and thus they can manifest the external symptoms on the body. There may be tears coming from their eyes and they may not have actually love in the heart. So he says that it is not necessary that if one has to chant, one chants, then there must be tears in the eyes or hair standing on the end, otherwise the heart is hard. So it is not necessary. And for this he quotes a verse from Rupa Goswami in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Yaduktam Srimad Rupa Goswami Charanam Svabhava Pichhala Swante तदभ्यास परे पिछे सत्वाभास बिना पिशु काप्य श्रुपुल कादे तथाति गंभीर महान अनुभाव भक्तेषु. सो ही दिस वर्स सेज दैट सम पीपल बाय नेचर दे हैव पिच्छल स्वभाव. What would be the proper word in English for this? Their heart is, you can say, very soft. Although literally, if you translate it, means it is very slippery. So for such people, for very small things, they start crying. They are not very strong-hearted. They have a weak heart, and like you call some people as sentimentalists. So very small thing they start crying, and they are very emotional type. So these types of people, they are called here as pichal swabhav. They have emotional heart, so sentimental. So when they may chant the name of the Lord, then without actually any pure devotion in the heart, they can have these symptoms in their body, that there are tears in their eyes or the hairs are standing in there. So there are examples like this. And there are also examples of people who practice this externally. They chant or hear the kirtan, and then they try to bring tear in their eyes. They practice crying there is a whole sampradaya, some sect of Gaudiya Vaishnavas. This is their sadhana, that they do kirtan, and while kirtan, either hearing or singing, they try to manifest these symptoms. And they think that by doing that, they will attain love of God. So instead of understanding that the symptoms are the outcome of love, they go from outside inside. Instead of thinking that when love is there in the heart, then the symptoms will manifest automatically, they think that if you can make the symptoms manifest, then the love will also become manifest. This is their philosophy. But Rupa Goswami does not agree with it. It's like when there are some germs in the body, then you get fever and there is a temperature in the body. But not that if you make your body hot, if you go outside in the sun and stand, your body becomes hot, you take the temperature, it may be 102 degrees. That doesn't mean that you have got actually fever. It's only external, but the real thing is inside. So he says that these sentimental type of people, they can manifest the symptoms without their heart actually being pure. Then on the other side we have another case. Tatha ati gambhir mahanubhava bhakteshu harinama bhis chitta drave api bahir ashru pulkadeyo na drishyante iti. And there are some very great devotees who have a very deep heart. And such people, although their heart melts, they don't manifest any external symptoms. So you may think that these people's heart has not melted because there are no symptoms. In other words, these external symptoms are not necessary and sufficient condition for love in the heart or melting of the heart. Because there are three possibilities that a person's heart melts and there are also symptoms manifest externally. Or his heart melts and there are no symptoms. Or there are symptoms and heart does not melt. And then of course, the heart does not manifest and there are no symptoms. That is the case with the people in general. So he is basically speaking to make this point that one should not become misguided just by seeing the external symptoms, that somebody is a devotee, because one can also just practice it. On the other hand, one should also not become misled, thinking there are no symptoms, and therefore the heart is not melting, or there is no love in the heart. One has to go a little more deeper, and therefore he gives further commentary on this. He says, tasmat padyam idam evam vyakhyayam. It's because there are these two deviations, therefore we need to explain this verse in a different manner. Yad hirdiyam na vikriyet kada yada vikaras tada apityat. It says that if the heart does not melt, even when there are transformations in the body, then it should be understood that the heart is like steel. So the verse basically is saying that external symptoms are not important. And even if there are external symptoms, it does not mean that the heart has melted. The main thing is that the heart should change. There should be transformation in the heart. And that is the real symptom of love or devotion. Vikara eva kastatraha netre jalam. And what are the external symptoms? He says, the verse says that netre jalam gatra ruhesu harsam. That there are tears in the eyes. Tatascha bahir ashru pulakayoho satorapi yad hirdayam na vikriyet tadasmasaram iti vakyat. So the real meaning of the verse is that even if there are tears in the eyes and the hair standing on the end, but the heart has not become soft, then one must understand that such a person's heart is like steel or iron. Tatascha hridaya vikriya lakshanani asadharanani shanti nam grahana shakti adini eva gyanam. So how do we know whether a person's heart has softened or become soft or has transformed? How will we know? Because usually we only see the symptoms of tears and the hair standing at the end. So how do we know that his heart has actually melted or not? So he says that the symptoms of heart changing because of devotion are as follows. And these are also described in Bhaktirasamrita Sindhu in the chapter of Bhav Bhakti. Shantir avyartha kalatvam viraktir mana shunyata asha bandha samutkantha nami gane sadaruchi asaktis tad gunakhyane pritis tad vasatis thale ityadyo anubhava sur jat bhavankure jana. So these are the various characteristics which are given here of a person who has attained Bhav Bhakti. The first is Shanti, means he is peaceful, he is not disturbed by material problems. Avyarth Kalatvam, it is not waste in time, in non-devotional activities or useless things which are not related to service to the Lord. Virakti, he is renounced to sense enjoyment. Manasunyata, and he has no pride, he is humble. Ashabandha, he has hope that he will meet the Lord. Samutkantha, and he is always eager to be engaged in service. Naam gane sadaruchi, and he always takes interest in singing the names of the Lord. Asaktis tad gunakhyane is very much attached to describing the qualities of the Lord. And pritis tad vasatis thale, he is also devoted to living in the abode of the Lord, such as Vrindavan. Ityadyo anubhavasu jat bhava ankure. So these are the characteristics which are found in a person who has attained bhava. Ashru pulkadini tu sadharanani. So these are the special qualities of such a person, of a pure devotee. And as far as tears in the eyes are concerned, they are the general characteristics. General means they can be in a devotee and they can also be in somebody who is really not a devotee. That is the meaning of general. Then he gives more explanation of this. I am also. Uttama adhikarinam nirvatsaranam nam grahane sati eva nam madhuryasya anubhavasyat tasmischa sati hridaya vikriya cha syat satyam cha tasyam tad vyanjakaha shanti adayo asu pulkadayascha bhavanti eva. Says when somebody is a top class devotee, uttama adhikari. And what is the symptom of a top class devotee? One symptom, it can be known from just this one quality, and that is nirmatsara. He or she does not have any envy, completely free from envy. So when such a person, he takes the name of the Lord, he chants or he hears the name of the Lord, then immediately he or she experiences the sweetness of the name. And because of this experience of the sweetness, there is a change in the heart. And then when there is a change in the heart, then that change becomes manifest externally. So just as when a person has loving sentiments for somebody, then it becomes manifest in his speech, on his face, in his behavior, activities, or if somebody is angry, then that is also visible in the face or the action or the speech. So similarly, when one experiences the sweetness of the name, then there is a change in the heart and this becomes manifest in the body. So these are the symptoms of Kshanti Adiyo Ashupulkade. He may become very peaceful and renounced. There may be symptoms of tears, etc. Kanishtha Adhikarinam Samatsaranam Tu Saparadh Chittatvat Nam Grahana Bahulyapi Tan Madhurya Anubhava Bhave Chittam Nai Vikriyet. But if somebody is not a Uttam Adhikari or high class devotee, he is a Kanishtha Adhikari, low class devotee, then he or she is Samatsara, is envious, there is envy in the heart, and therefore his heart is possessed by the offense. And even if he or she chants or hears the name of the Lord repeatedly, there is no change in the heart. The heart does not melt because such a devotee does not experience the sweetness of the name. And thus there are no symptoms manifest externally. Tesam eva ashrupulkadi sattvepi asmasartaya hridayataya nindai. So if such people whose hearts have not melted like this, if they manifest symptoms of tears or hair standing on the hand or trembling of the body, then you must know that actually they are very hard-hearted. They may be emotional, but the heart is very hard. Usually we think that such people have a soft heart. The people who are emotional or sentimental, we think that such people are very emotional because they can start crying if somebody is suffering, they become very empathetic and so on. But according to this verse, actually their heart is not soft at all. Although the external symptoms appear like that. So such people, they are criticized in this verse. They are not praised. Kincha tesham api sadhu sangena anarth nivritti nishtha ruchyadi bhumikarudhanam kalena chitta drugve sati chittasya asmasaratvam apagacchati. But even if such people, they associate with some great devotee, then their anarthas, the offenses, will be removed. And when the offenses are removed, then they will attain fixity in devotion. And then slowly they will get a taste, then they will become attached, and then they will attain bhava, or come to the platform of love. Then they will also manifest the symptoms. Yesham tu chitta dravayapi sati chittasya asmasarta tishthe deva tetu duschikitsya eva geya. But there are people whose heart may melt, but still they remain strong or hard-hearted. Means they just manifest the external symptom, then it is very difficult to do anything for them. तथा च वक्षते तृतीये सबीज योग ध्याने. So the example of such people is, because this is a very peculiar example, he says that chitta dravayapi chittasya asmasartha, that their heart melts, and yet he says that their heart is hard like steel. So how is this possible that both things happen? This is a very peculiar case. Earlier we had the cases that heart melts but there are no symptoms manifest, or symptoms manifest but the heart doesn't melt. And he says that here the heart melts and still the heart is hard. It's like a stone piece. So how is that it melts and still it remains hard? So there is one particular type of people, person who has such nature. And these are the people who want to realize Brahman. And for that they perform devotional service to the Lord. And when they engage in devotional service to the Lord with this intention to realize Brahman, they come to the level where they can even realize the Lord in their heart. And by seeing the Lord, they manifest the symptoms of tears and hair standing on the end and so on. Yet they don't become surrender to the Lord. They don't get the desire to perform service to the Lord. And therefore they pull back their mind, which they had fixed on the Lord. And then they just remain absorbed in Brahman. So such people's heart also melts because they realize the Lord. Yet they don't become interested in it. Because this is not their purpose. Devotion is not their goal. Their goal is impersonal liberation. So this example is given in the third canto, in the teachings of Lord Kapila to Devahuti. And this is the verse from there. It says, Evam harau bhagavati pratilabdha bhavo भक्त्या द्रवद हृदय उत्पुलक प्रमोदात् अकंठ बाष्प कलया मुहुरर्धमान तच्चापि चित्त बर्षम शनकैर्वियुङ्क्ते. So earlier to this verse, Lord Kapila has given a process how the yogi, he meditates on the form of the Lord, as we also read in the second chapter. And by meditation like this, he actually sees the Lord and he attains bhava. But he says that this bhava is pratilabdha bhava. It is not the bhava to do favorable service to the Lord. And at that stage his heart melts out of devotion and he feels great pleasure or happiness, and the hairs stand on the end, and atkanthya baspa kalaya, there are tears in the eyes, and thus the heart is melted again and again. But then what he does is that slowly he pulls out his heart from this meditation on the Lord. So this is a very peculiar example. Atra dravad hridaya iti chitta drava. So in this verse the word dravad hridaya means chitta drava, means his heart melts. Tach chitta badisham iti chittasya asma salta. Yet his heart is compared to the hook of a fisherman. Like a fisherman, he has his hook and he throws it into the pond or river to catch fish. So this hook is there to catch the fish, but once you catch the fish, it is not that he has any love or affection for the fish. This hook actually pierces into the live fish. So similarly, the yogi uses his heart to capture the Lord. But once he captures the Lord, he is not interested in devotional service. He has his own motive, and that is to realize Brahman. Just as a fisherman catches the fish, and he gives him little food also, he puts a bait on the hook. But that is not really for the pleasure of the fish. That bait is like his death. So similarly, yogi is using bhakti only to attract the Lord. Just as fisherman uses the bait to attract the fish. And when the Lord is there in the heart, then he rejects. But he only wants Brahman realization. So such people's heart melts and yet it remains hard. It's a very inconceivable situation. Badisasya lohamayatvat asmasarasya lohaparyatvat. He says this hook is made of iron. In the same way his heart is as if made of iron. Pratilabdho bhavo ye naiti bhavo ayam abhas rupa eva. So now he says that in reality his devotion is not real devotion. It is only a semblance of it. And therefore his melting of the heart is also not real. So just as we said earlier that the external symptoms can become manifest without melting of the heart, in the same way it appears that his heart has melted, but really didn't melt. Because if his heart would have melted, then he will become devoted to the Lord and he would like to only render service and not be interested in liberation. And it's like Dhruv Maharaj. To begin with, he was interested in getting a big kingdom bigger than his father. But when he saw the Lord, then he was not interested in anything material. His mind changed and he only wanted service to the Lord. And although the Lord gave him what he wanted, that is kingdom, but Dhruva was not happy with that. He thought that he has been cheated. So his heart really melted. His heart was not hard. But these types of yogis who are interested only in realizing Brahman, they even meditate on the form of the Lord and perform service, yet they are not interested in service. Yathārthatve sankair viyunkta iti tasya purushārtha buddhya hi tyāganupatti. So he says that in reality slowly they remove their heart from the Lord, they don't meditate on it anymore. And if the goal to begin with was pure devotion, then it will not be possible that one realizes the Lord in the heart and then gives him up. Ateva tadrish dhyana bhaktya api ayam bhakta sabdena na abhidhiyate kintu yogi sabdena. Therefore, although they perform meditation on the Lord's form, this should be considered as bhakti, because it is part of smaran. But it is not called bhakti. Such people, they are called only yogi. They are not called devotees, because their real purpose is not in devotion. Chittasya badishatvena कठोरत्व कुटिलत्व अभ्याम तद विषयस्य भगवदंगस्य दुखदान एव पर्याप्त है. सो इट इज जस्ट एज दिस हुक, इट इज वेरी हार्ड, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज एबल टू पियर्स द फिश, एंड इट इज नॉट स्ट्रेट, इट इज क्रूकेड. सो इट सेज दैट दिस पीपल्स हार्ट इज आल्सो लाइक दैट, इट इज नॉट स्ट्रेट हार्ट, दे आर क्रूकेड इन देयर हार्ट एंड दे आर वेरी हार्ड. एंड दस although they perform service to the Lord, it is not pleasing to him and they only give pain, just as this hook gives pain to the fish, although seemingly it also gives little food, some warmth. So therefore such meditation is not pleasing to the Lord. एवं च सावाग यया तस्य गुणान गृणीते करौ च तत्कर्म करौ इत्यादि वक्षमान वाक्यैर अन्वयेन बिलेबत इत्यादि वाक्यैर व्यतिकरेण च भक्तेन एव शास्त्र विधेयत्वं दृढ़ीकृत. सो बाय स्पीकिंग दिस वर्स शौनक ऋषि ही हैज फॉर्मली एस्टेब्लिश्ड दैट द स्पिरिचुअल प्रैक्टिस फॉर एवरीबडी is to engage in devotion, as was also spoken by Sukhdev Goswami earlier, because there have been statements that which will come later on, that that is the speech which is engaged in the service of the Lord, those are the hands which perform service to the Lord. So those are the positive statements, and negative statements are that those are those ears which do not hear about the Lord, they are the holes of the snake, and those hands which do not engage in the service of the Lord, they are the hands of a dead body. So both by positive statements and negative statements, it is only the devotion to the Lord which has been established as the vidheya or the prescription, nothing else. And that is the conclusion of all the statements spoken by Swami. Stop here.